It is absent. And next muscle, it is musculus sterna clade mastoideus. It starts from the sternum, from clavicle, and attached to mastoid process of the temporal bone. Next groove, medial muscles of the neck, divides into muscles above of hyoid bone and muscles below of hyoid bone. Muscles below of hyoid bone are musculus sterna hyoideus, from sternum to hyoid bone. Sterna thyroideus, go to thyroid cartilage. Tirohyoideus, from thyroid cartilage to hyoid bone. And omohyoideus, from scapula and go to hyoid bone. Musculus omohyoideus has two ventres, inferior and superior, and between them intermediate tendon. Muscles above of hyoid bone are digastric muscle, musculus digastricus. It also consists of two ventres, ventral anterior and ventral posterior. Then musculus stylohyoideus, from styloid process to hyoid bone. Musculus millehyoideus, do you remember sulcus millehyoideus on the mandible? And go to hyoid bone, musculus millehyoideus. And above of musculus millehyoideus, from spina mentalis to hyoid bone, pass musculus geniohyoideus. And deep muscles of the neck. First of all, three scalenus muscles. Musculus scalenus anterior, musculus scalenus medius, and musculus scalenus posterior. Anterior and medial muscles attached to first rib. If you remember, on the first rib was tubercle, tuberculum, musculi, scalene, anterioris. And behind of this tubercle groove of subclavial artery, and behind of this groove, place where attached medial scalenus muscle. And posterior muscle attached to the second rib. Next, musculus longus coli, musculus longus capitis, musculus rectus capitis anterior and lateral.
Good morning.
Good morning. What happened?
No,
oh, wait. Wait, your turn outside. Mm-hmm. Okay. Next. Muscles of the head. Muscles of the head divide into muscles of mastication and muscles of facial expression. Muscles of mastication are musculus temporalis, start from temporal fossa and attached to coronary process of the mandible, processus coronalis. Do you remember this process?
Yes.
Musculus masseter start from zygomatic arch and attached to tuberositas masseterica on the mandible. And two pterygoid muscles. Musculus pterygoideus medialis and musculus pterygoideus lateralis. Both of them start from pterygoid process and inferior surface of greater veins of sphenoidal bone and attach medial muscle attached to tuberositas pterygoidea, lateral muscle attached to the neck of mandible and to cartilage discus articularis. Function. All of these muscles move mandible upward. Lateral pterygoid muscles, if they contract together, they move mandible forward. Posterior fibers of musculus temporalis move mandible backward. And if musculus pterygoideus only on one side contract, they move mandible in opposite side. These muscles has fascia. Musculus temporalis has fascia temporalis. Musculus masseter, the same fascia, fascia masseterica. And in front from meatus acousticus externus, it is parotid gland, and parotid gland surround with parotid fascia, fascia parotidea. Another muscles it is muscles of the facial expression, and they have not got ligaments, fascia here it is are absent. First muscle, it is muscle of the roof of the skull, musculus epicranius. It has venter frontalis and venter occipitalis, and also in the region of auricula present three auricular muscles, musculus auricularis posterior, musculus auricularis superior, and musculus auricularis anterior. In the region of orbita present musculus orbicularis oculi, and it has three parts, pars orbitalis attached to the walls of orbita, pars palpebralis on the eyelids, and pars lacrimalis in the region of lacrimal sac. Next muscle, it is musculus procerus, here it is. And next muscle is absent, should be here. Musculus corrugator supercilii. Muscles in the region of mouth, here it is. Musculus orbicularis oris. Musculus levator labii superioris. Musculus levator labii superioris. It's lift upper lip. Musculus zygomaticus major and minor. Musculus levator anguli oris. It's lift angle of the mouth. Musculus risorius. It is muscle of the smile. It starts from the skin of the chin and attached to angle of the mouth. Musculus depressor anguli oris. Musculus depressor labii inferioris and musculus mentalis. It is necessary to know only names all of these muscles. Next moment. Topography of the neck. Neck has four regions. Anterior region, in front from musculus sternocleidomastoideus. All of this region is anterior region of the neck. Posterior region, it's posteriorly, it's above of which muscle? What is the name of this muscle? Musculus? No. Levator scapulae here. This muscle, it is musculus trapezius. Above of trapezius muscle, posterior region of the neck. Regio cervicalis posterior. Between trapezius and sternocleidomastoideus muscle, this region, it is lateral region of the neck, regio cervicalis lateralis. And last, it is regio sternocleidomastoideus, its projection of sternocleidomastoid muscle. Two regions, anterior and lateral, divides into triangles. Okay, here it is musculus omohaidus. This muscle pass in these two regions, in lateral and in anterior. And with the help of this muscle, lateral region divides into trigonum omoclaviculare, here, trigonum omotrapezoideum, here, and here trigonum omotracheale, because here it is larynx and trachea. Trigonum omo tracheale. Next triangle. It's between musculus omohaidus, musculus digastricus, and musculus sternocleidomastoideus. This triangle has name trigonum caroticum, because carotid artery pass in this triangle, and we can press it to anterior cubital of 6 cervical vertebrae. Do you remember the name of this tubercle? Tuberculum caroticum. We can do it in this triangle. And next, submandibular triangle, trigonum retromandibulare, trigonum retromandibulare. It's between mandible and two ventors of both ventors of musculus digastricus. And inside of this triangle, smaller triangle, Pyragovs, because this scientist, Russian scientist, describes this triangle, and it has name Pyragovs triangle. It has anterior wall musculus millehidus, posterior wall musculus digastricus, and superior wall, if is absent, should be nervus hypoglossus. In this triangle, lingual artery pass, and we can tie this artery if it is necessary to do in time of bleeding. That is topography of the neck. And now sit down and I explain the fascia of the neck.